All right, here's the best part for Lauren Miller Rogan, is that this big Netflix movie, super great cast, and a super great billboard. I think everyone searches for that endorsement. And so you posted a picture of yourself by the billboard.
Yes.
Let's discuss.
As you should. I was driving down Fairfax last week and was like, what is that teal? Oh my God, it's our movie. And I almost drove off the road. I FaceTimed with my dad as I was driving up to it.
Aww.
Yeah,
oh, what did he think?
He's yelling all over the place. He can't stop crying. He's backstage right now.
Sobbing still?
Yes,
has it been a nonstop cry the entire time?
He got into the car this morning and was like, I read a review. And he's
So here's the thing. You've done some short films before.
Yes.
But this is a big deal with a really big cast.
Yeah, it's a whole long movie.
How did this all come about?
It was amazing. I wrote the script starting about 6 years ago, and it was an idea that was pitched to me by Anders Bard, who was the producer, and we wrote it and eventually just decided, hey, let's try to make this thing and let's give me the chance to direct it. And off we went, and eventually Netflix came on board, and thank God, then we found Kristen and Kelsey, and now we have a movie.
And we were talking about Kelsey Grammer and Kristen Bell. I mean, very formidable stars. And you were saying, I suspect it's true of both of them, but when he would do these scenes,
There's some really, I mean, the movie has a lot of funny moments, and you know, it takes place on a cruise ship, it's a colorful world, but it's also very real and very grounded, and has some really emotional scenes, and both of them, what they brought to the table is so extraordinary. We would be off camera crying.
Really?
I mean, just, it was like an honor to watch. It was like watching, like, extraordinary actors, like, do a play sometimes. It was just an honor to direct both of them.
And then, here's the movie you're directing that you've written, and you're seeing it performed. Is that outer body, particularly when it's going well?
I mean, it's honestly, when you're a writer and you're alone in your house, like typing, you always imagine, you envision great actors saying your words. But, you know, having people like them do it, it's really just such an honor.
All right. We have a clip, conveniently enough. Take a look at this. It's gonna be dropping on Netflix later this week. Watch.
How did you know what I do for a living?
Google. It's not hard to find out information about anybody these days. Saying you never Googled me.
No. Why would I have done that? My wedding, my job. You read a lot about me, huh?
Everything I could find. You really never Googled me.
No.
See, what I like here is they take their time.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, they really, it's like I said, we've created this really grounded world. Rachel, at the beginning of the movie, has been left at the altar, and her dad, who she has not seen since she was 5 years old, who is Kelsey, has shown up, and one thing leads to the next, and they end up on her honeymoon together.
Oh, wow.
And so, as you can imagine, this leads to a lot of discussions just like this, where they're sort of filling in the blanks of the past 26 years that they haven't seen each other. So there are a lot of these moments that are surrounded by fun, but really sort of other moments that tug at the heartstrings.
All right, speaking of, I don't know if this tugs at the heartstrings or not, Seth Rogen is your husband.
He is.
He's in it.
He is.
Directable or not directable?
And when I say not that, directable.
At home or doing the movie? Yeah.
Very directable at home.
Okay.
No, he's great all around, all the time, home or in the movies. He's my favorite person, so, you know, he's...
Now, would your crying father agree with all this?
I think so, most of the time.
he approves, yeah.
No, I mean, I think he's the most talented filmmaker that I've ever been around, and so having him around was such an amazing gift for me, to have the person that I trust the most to ask of his opinion, but also he was really respectful, and he got what I was setting out to do, and I really had a clear vision from the beginning that he was happy to get on board and support.
And then what about this persona that he's baked all the time?
I mean, you know, he smokes weed. It's, you know, it's legal here in California. You don't have to be a stoner and just be sitting on the couch eating munchies all the time. You can be completely productive and have a very thriving career just like he does, just while you're smoking weed.
There it is. All right.
California, guys.
All has been explained. Like Father, available on Netflix, as we said, August 3rd. Really nice to meet you.
Thank you, Lauren.
Thank you.
Congratulations. For having me.